Suppose you want to know if the ASCII message got to the ViewMarq display okay. No problem. Just make sure that the ASCII reply option is enabled here in the LED display configuration. That's this checkbox right here. That's it. Ours is already set up, so we just close that out. And when you create your message, make sure you create the message with an ID that's not zero. Remember, zero is a broadcast message. Back in the Do More software, we simply add a stream in instruction to our code. This is the simple ASCII message example we did in a previous video, where we just form the message here and we send it out the serial port here. To read the response back from the ViewMarq, all we do is add a stream in instruction. We want to read from the internal serial port, and we'll read characters until we fill up our buffer, or we get that single carriage return that the ViewMarq's going to send back to mark the end of the message. And let's go ahead and put that result into a string long number 10. How about that? That's all there is to it. Let's enable this instruction with switchX1. Now, while I'm using an edge-triggered contact here, I really didn't need to because this instruction is already edge-triggered. So again, all we're doing is formatting the string, making sure that the ID is not zero, sending that string out to serial port, and then reading the serial port to see what the reply from the ViewMarq is. Let's go ahead and accept our changes, save it, write it out to the PLC. Let's turn on the status for everybody so we can see what's going on. So I'm going to reach down, then I'm going to toggle X0 on this processor. And that created the message for us. You can see that message appeared in string long 0 right here, and that its length was 234 characters. Let's go ahead and add our string long 10 for the result right here. And let's go ahead and add our length too. So now that we've formatted our string and placed it in string long 0, I'm going to toggle X7 to send that message down to the ViewMarq. So now I just reach down to the Do More and toggle X1. And sure enough, we got a message back from the ViewMarq saying everything was okay, and it was 3 characters long. Now we know that the message was successfully received by the ViewMarq. The key points here are, send the message to a single ID, not the broadcast ID of 0, and make sure that the ASCII reply is configured in the ViewMarq. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. Check out the other videos for doing the same thing using Modbus and other advanced features. And let us know if you have any questions. Automation Direct's customer support is always free and just a phone call or email away. Spend less. Do more with Automation Direct.